Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6, Chapter 1, The History of the Life of Ajamila, Text 42. Suryognikham arudevaha somasandhyahani dishaha kam kusvayam dharma iti kete daihyasya sakshinaha. Translation. The sun, fire, sky, air, demigods, moon, evening, day, night, directions, water, land and supersoul himself all witness the activities of the living entity. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The members of some religious sects, especially Christians, do not believe in the reactions of karma. We once had a discussion with a learned Christian professor who argued that although people are generally punished after the witnesses of their misdeeds are examined, where are the witnesses responsible for one suffering the reactions of past karma? To such a person, the answer by the Yamadutas is given here. A conditioned soul thinks that he is working stealthily, that no one can see his sinful activities. But we can understand from the Shastras that there are many witnesses, including the sun, fire, sky, air, moon, demigods, evening, day, night, directions, water, land, and the super soul himself, who sits with the individual soul within his heart. Where is the dearth of witnesses? The witnesses and the Supreme Lord both exist, and therefore so many living entities are elevated to higher planetary systems or degraded to lower planetary systems, including the hellish planets. There are no discrepancies, for everything is arranged perfectly by the management of the Supreme God. Svabhaviki jnana balakriyacha. The witnesses mentioned in this verse are also mentioned in other Vedic literatures. Aditya Chandrav Anilo Analascha Dyaur Bhumir Apo Hridayam Yamascha Ahascha Ratrischa Ubhecha Sandhye Dharmo Pijana Tinarasya Vrittam. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purport. So the Yamadutas are explaining to the Vishnu Dutas, why are they being stopped from taking Ajamila, who was sinful and the way they determine that somebody is sinful is because there are witnesses under the direction of the Supreme Lord Narayana. There are witnesses who are actually witnessing every activity of every living entity within the whole universe. So how many witnesses are there? Plenty. So the witnesses are being mentioned here. Surya, the sun. Now sun means, at least in the daytime, the sun spreads itself by sunshine, sunlight. This example we have heard many times. But try to understand the example itself in this connection. Sunshine is spread everywhere, but the sun is present in the sun planet. The sun god is in the sun planet. But sunshine is everywhere, spread everywhere. Sun god is not spread everywhere. But through sunshine, the sun god is also present everywhere. So when it is said, sun is the witness, that means not the disk, not the impersonal sunshine, it is the sun god, the person. So sun god is the witness. Then agnihi, fire, fire again, fire god. Fire God is present wherever there is fire. Just like Sun God is present wherever there is sunshine. Similarly, sky means space. Sky is everywhere. Everywhere. Everywhere there is space. So there is Srila Prabhupada explains, actually, even more important than considering the controllers of each of these, it is important to understand that the Supreme Lord is present everywhere. In so many ways He is present. As Super Soul, He has entered into everything that is created. Yes? What is that last verse of the 10th chapter? Athava bahunaitena kim jnatena tavarjuna vishthabhyaham idam krishnam ekamshena stito jagat. Vishthabhya aham idam krishnam. Krishna is telling Arjuna, what need is there for all these details about how Krishna is present in this material world in so many different manifestations? No need for these details. Because his opulence is limitless, Krishna stopped after telling 82 opulences. And he said, just understand that I have entered into everything. Idam Krishnam. Krishnam means totality of everything manifested. Heart of every living entity. So living entity is the spiritual atom, as Prabhupada says. So heart of every living entity means into that spiritual atom, as Paramatma Krishna has entered. Into everything material that is created, every material atom also He has entered. Andantarastha paramanu chayantarastham. Every planet He has entered. Gama vishyacha bhutani dharayami ahamojasa. So, Krishna has entered into everything as Super Soul, and He is present everywhere. But we should also remember one more important fact. Krishna says in the 7th chapter, Bhumi rapo nalo vayu kham mano buddhirevacha ahankara iti yamme bhinna prakriti rashtadha. These are my 8 separated energies. Bhinna prakriti means separated energies. So, directly we cannot see Krishna within these energies, within these manifestations, sky or water or land. But Krishna Himself is non-different from His energies. Shakti Shakti Matayor Abhedaha. There is no difference between the Lord, the personal Lord, the person, God the person, Krishna, and His energies. He is Shaktiman, and His energies are called Shakti. There is no difference. That means He is His energy. Energy is Him. At the same time, Krishna has His individuality, His separate identity as the person apart from His energies. This is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching us. Achintya Bheda Abheda Tattva. The truth, absolute truth, is inconceivably one and different as the Supreme Person and His energies. So what is in existence is nothing but God. There is only God in existence and nothing else. But God in existence means God with His energies. And His energies are multifarious. Many, 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 many varieties of energies. But they can be broadly classified into three. That's how the scriptures classify the various categories into three essential categories. Internal, external, marginal. This you have heard many times. So all these energies are Krishna Himself. Krishna Himself. So when it is said, sky is witness, it is Krishna who is a witness as the sky. So sky is, or space is everywhere. Air is also everywhere. Without, since living entities are everywhere in God's creation, so living entities cannot live without air. They cannot live without space. So, therefore, air is also everywhere. Air is described as all-pervading. Sky is described as all-pervading. So, as the different manifestations, Krishna is present everywhere. So he is a witness. Devatas, demigods. Now so many devatas are there. Every single manifestation is controlled by a devata. Every planet, there are millions of planets. Each planet, there is a devata. Every element that is controlled, like water is controlled, all water bodies are controlled. So then there, every planet is controlled, sky is controlled, wind is controlled, fire is controlled. So there are devatas for each of these. And devatas means not just one devata for fire, Agnideva. Agnideva is the chief. He has got so many assistants, so many subordinates. It's a very elaborate arrangement. So there are 33 crore devatas. 33 crore. So all of them are witness in different spheres of their own sphere of control. They are witnesses. Control means they have got an eye on what each living being is doing in terms of utilizing or in terms of the permission given to utilize. Just like air is there, but suddenly somebody feels very breathless. Right? Somebody feels breathless. They're not able to breathe. Then lack of this oxygen supply, if within some, they say some 3 minutes or something, again, they don't get that oxygen, they're going to collapse. And after collapsing also, within certain amount of time, if they are not supplied artificially this oxygen, then they go to die. So air is available, but the supply is controlled. That we should remember. supply is controlled. So these devatas who are controlling every single thing that is supplied is controlled. So there are higher laws of control. Ultimately, all the devatas are working under the direction of Krishna. All the devatas. So above every devata, there is the Supreme Lord. In fact, he is directly controlling by sitting in their hearts as the Super Soul. He is directly present in everybody's heart as Super Soul. So he is controlling them. And through them, he is controlling everything. The Supreme Lord. That's how he is a supreme controller, ultimate controller. So like this, there are so many witnesses. All these witnesses are actually seeing every single activity that every living entity is doing. So therefore, we cannot do anything secretly. We cannot do anything without our activity being recorded, noticed, what activity we are doing. So for every single sinful activity, at least for the sinful activities, we are responsible and we have to get the reaction. And when the reaction will come, according to Kala. Kala is another manifestation of the Supreme Lord only as Paramatma. So the Lord will decide when, where, how we are going to get the reaction. It's not in our hands. So reactions are there. And the reactions will be given. So Yamaraj is the chief of all these Yamadutas who actually bring the living being who is very, very sinful to Yamaraj. Grievous sinful activities have to immediately be dealt with. Immediately means immediately after quitting this body at the time of death. So the Yamadutas have come to take Ajamila. So when they are being stopped, they are telling there are so many witnesses. Not that we have simply come by mistake. There are so many witnesses to whatever Ajamila has done. And they have reported. Based on that report we have come. What all mistakes he has done. What all sinful activities he has performed. So, like that, the argument by some people that where are the witnesses? Just because we cannot see the witness doesn't mean there are no witnesses. Same argument. Where is the spirit soul? So we cannot see. We cannot perceive. We cannot detect. By our instruments. So therefore it's not there. This is foolishness. This is foolishness. Similarly, the witnesses are there. And every sinful activity is witnessed. And therefore there is punishment. That is definitely there. By, as decided by Yamaraj. Who's perfect. There cannot be any mistake. There cannot be any mistake. So nobody is innocent. Sometimes people say, oh, he is such a nice person. Why is he suffering so much? And sometimes they even say, why is God giving him so much suffering? As if God is at fault. That's the way sometimes they speak. Sometimes out of sentiment, sometimes even in a challenging way they say this. But actually what they don't realize is that in this world, as soon as somebody accepts a material body, it should be understood that such a person actually is forced to accept the material body because of the past karma, because of the past sinful activities. Only because sinful activities, there is a need to accept a material body. Otherwise, there is no need for accepting material body. We don't require a material body. You don't require to accept a material body. And material body means bondage, means suffering. Even Brahma, the topmost created being, is embodied. Brahma is also embodied because he has got a material covering. And that material covering also, now somebody may wonder, what is Brahma suffering? Brahma doesn't suffer like us. But you just study the Bhagavatam. When Hiranyakashipu terrorized the whole universe, Brahma is in so much anxiety. My God. What to do with this fellow? I myself gave him the boons. And now he's misusing. What can I do? So Brahma has to go to Vishnu and pray to Vishnu, please do something. Now, it's not that Brahma has carelessly given these boons to Hiranyakashipu. Please don't think like that. To immediately solve the problem, he had to, because Hiranyakashipu, even before he got the boons, what was he doing? He was practicing severe austerities. And those austerities were disturbing the whole universal arrangement. When somebody is fasting and restraining the pranavayu in such a way that the body is kept alive, the mechanism is kept alive, working condition, by manipulating this pranavayu circulation. And as a result of that, in the case of Hiranyakashipu, the type of penance he was doing, there was a fire coming out of the top of the head, that Brahmarandhra, that opening at the top of the head. And that fire increased in intensity and started heating up the whole universe. So much so that the controller of fire is unable to do anything. Then, what will he do? Agni Deva, what will he do if he is unable to control? He'll go to Brahma. Brahma says, I also cannot do anything. Then all of them had to go to Vishnu. So Vishnu said, I will take care of it at the appropriate time. So they're all waiting. When will Vishnu deal with this? And his terrorist activities are increasing. So, Brahma didn't immediately go to Vishnu. He came down and said, let me just use my mystic power to pacify this fellow, this Hiranyakashipu. So he came, took some water from his kamandalu, sprinkled. Immediately the fire is put off. Brahma is powerful. Definitely Brahma is very, very powerful. So immediately the problem is solved. But Hiranyakashipu is asking so many things. Otherwise, again he will start doing this tapasya. Again he will disturb. He is capable. He is capable of doing that tapasya, that kind of tapasya. So, in order to pacify him, Brahma put out that fire But then he is demanding, I should not be killed by this, by that, by this, by this. Okay. Brahma knows this fellow is thinking he will not die. But actually death cannot be avoided. So he said, okay, you will not be killed by an animal, you will not be killed by. But death will come. Death is not only because of any of these reasons that we think, oh, he died because of some heart failure. Heart failure, he died. Or some accident, he died. They attribute some cause, some reason. But actually, the real cause of death is none of these. When the lifespan is over, when the duration of life is over, we are forced to quit the body. So therefore, the cause of death is different, and the suffering or the pain or some kind of inconvenience we experience during the our stay in this body, that is different. The two should not be mixed up. You have heard sometimes people, they are in coma. So then in comatose condition, people will, somebody, others, relatives will think, oh, he's going to die, this person is going to die. But actually, after being in coma, person comes back and then lives a very normal life. Sometimes, after being in comatose condition, they die. But how long will this comatose condition last? Nobody can figure out. Even astrologers, expert astrologers, are sometimes unable to figure out. I know a particular case of a devotee. His mother went into coma and she was in a comatose condition for 4 years. 4 years she was in a comatose condition. So he consulted astrologers just to understand. But the astrologers were not able to tell this 4 years she is going to be like that in comatose condition. They were telling, oh, another 3 months, another 6 months, some of them told. The most expert astrologers. So it is not, very easy to figure out like that. So I explained this point to this devotee. That you see, duration of life is different and the suffering due to some coma or whatever, that medical condition of the body is different. So, the two should not be mixed up. So, the duration of life, that is controlled, that can be increased or reduced. Even though a certain duration is fixed at the time of our entering this body, at the time of birth, but that can be changed in the course of our life in this body. Just like the Kauravas, their duration of life became reduced because they insulted Draupadi. So they died untimely death. It's called Akala Mrityu. Akala Mrityu means they don't live their full duration which they got at the time of birth. They don't live their full duration of life. Somebody's duration of life, let us say, is 100 years. By blessings of saintly persons who are capable of blessing like that, they can live 120 years, 150 years, 700 years. Very long life. Formerly, you would have heard or seen in some TV serials, Ayushman Bhava. They will give this blessing, no? What it actually means is that you live long. So that living long can be the full duration, 100 years, without untimely death. That is understood. Ayushman Bhava means that. It can also mean live 200 years or 500 years or 700 years or 1000 years. So, this duration of life is something which is not easy to determine or understand. So, we live our duration of life. So, in one lecture, Prabhupada says, in one discourse, that as devotees, we know Krishna is the witness to all our activities. So, because of this understanding, at least as a devotee, we should completely give up all sinful activities. Because Krishna is witness. We cannot do anything without Krishna seeing what we are doing. Never possible. Krishna is witness. So, never do any sinful activity. Also, Bhagavad Gita says, Yesham tu antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam te dvandva moha nirmukta bhajante mam vridavrataha. So, you can take to devotional service properly and become fixed up if you become completely free from all sinful activities. Antagatam papam. Therefore, Prabhupada explains, the beginning is, we take vow, we will not do four types of sinful activities. But that's just the beginning, that's the time of initiation. Initiation means the beginning of our spiritual life. Under proper guidance of a bona fide spiritual master and following his instructions, etc. But then we have to make progress. So what is the progress? All other types of sinful activities, we have got to completely stop. All other types of sinful activities, even minor violations. Sin means violation of scriptures. So, all types of violations we have to stop. For that, what is the way? Krishna himself says, Yesham tu antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam. We have to become engaged, not just stopping sinful activity. No, we have to become positively engaged in punyakarmanam. What is this punyakarmanam? Devotional service. You have heard many times earlier, three kinds of pious activities. Bhogonmukha punya, mokshonmukha punya, and bhaktionmukha punya. So what Krishna means here is we should do bhaktionmukha punya, devotional activities, which are the highest, topmost grade of pious activities. Topmost grade, because they give us Krishna. We are able to attain Krishna. As a result of devotional service, we get Krishna. So we have to do devotional service. So we have to become engaged in devotional service. And the perfection is we are completely engaged in devotional service so that there is no chance of any sinful activity at all. All the time engaged in devotional service. That's why Prabhupada says, 24 hours a day engaged in serving Krishna. So then, that is perfection of antagatam papam. And that way, Prabhupada says, no more sinful activities, but more importantly, rather than we trying to see God, we should act in such a way that God will see us. So Krishna is seeing. As far as the non-devotees are concerned, Krishna is seeing what sinful activities are doing, and according to that, they are going to get the reactions. Or even pious activities. But it is all simply bondage. Devotees, Krishna wants to see that you stop all sinful activities and you engage in devotional service so that he will reveal himself to you. He'll reveal himself to you. And the perfection of our devotional services, premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva hrudayeshu vilokayanti, that we are able to perfect our devotional service, to be able to smear our eyes with the ointment of love for Krishna. We come to the stage of Krishna prema, where we will be able to see Krishna everywhere. There is a verse in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Sthavara jangama dekhe na dekhe tara murti. Beautiful verse. Sthavara jangama dekhe na dekhe tara murti. Sarvatra haya nija ishta deva spurti. So the devotee is able to see because his eyes are smeared with the ointment of love of God. He is able to see everywhere only Krishna. Whatever he sees Krishna. Because Krishna and his energy, everything is Krishna's energy in this world. So Krishna's energy is also Krishna. That's how the devotee sees Krishna. He does not see the creation, but he sees the creator. Creation and creator. Krishna is a creator and he has created this whole creation. So, devotee sees the creator. Non-devotee see the creation. So, we should come to that stage that we'll be able to see Krishna everywhere. And that's the perfection. So, this witness means we want Krishna to see us not for the sake of noting down which sinful activity we have done. No. But he will see us engaged very nicely in his seva and devotional service. And then we will be able to re-establish our loving relationship with him. And then we, that way we perfect our life. Okay, I'll stop here. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Shri Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.